my friend. Welcome back to Space Enjoyer. Have you ever thought about the fact that everything that surrounds us here on our planet Earth appeared and exists thanks to a small star, the Sun? As Carl Sagan said,
"The cosmos is also within us. We're made of star stuff. We are a way for the cosmos to know itself."
It is hard to imagine, but only in our galaxy, the Milky Way, there are from 1 to 400 billion stars. But how are the stars themselves born? In this video, we will try to understand this. According to modern ideas, stars are born from a gas dusty diffuse medium through a process of gravitational contraction of individual gas clouds by their own gravity. Gravitational contraction starts in the densest regions of interstellar gas, where a few percent of the matter is concentrated in solid particles called interstellar dust. Let's try to find out what it is and what it consists of. In photographs of the stellar sky, especially in regions of the Milky Way, you can see a strong heterogeneity of the distribution of stars caused by the presence of opaque matter. A prime example of objects of this type are the dark nebulae known as the horsehead and the coal sack. For example, the size of the coal sack is about 8 parsecs. The contrast with the surrounding bright regions of the Milky Way makes the nebula appear as a black spot. Faint stars can be seen through the telescope in this region, which are several times fewer than the number of stars in neighboring regions of the same size. The coal sack absorbs light from distant stars, reducing the total amount of light by about a factor of 4. Many coal sack-like clouds from a broad, dark band along the Milky Way's midline, starting from the constellation Cygnus and extending through the constellations Aquila, Serpens, Sagittarius, and Scorpius. This is the famous fork in the Milky Way. Dark clouds are especially numerous in the central gyre of our galaxy, in the constellation Sagittarius, making this an extremely interesting area to view. The interstellar medium mainly absorbs shortwave radiation, which is why the light of distant stars experiences interstellar reddening of light. The reddening of light is caused by the same substance that causes light absorption. The observed attenuation of light is experienced when it passes through a medium made up of small solid particles. If their diameter is on the order of the wavelength of radiation and averages between 0.1 and 1 micrometers. However, there are also a considerable number of smaller particles that mainly absorb ultraviolet radiation. Large particles consist of a refractory core and a shell of volatile elements. Refractory particles can form at temperatures from 500 to 2000 Kelvin in the cold atmospheres of giants and supergiants of late spectral classes and in the shells of supernova remnants and planetary nebulae. Dust particles are only a small fraction of the matter of the interstellar medium. The bulk of its mass is interstellar gas. In most of the interstellar medium, gas and dust are thought to be fairly evenly mixed together, with an average mass ratio of 100 to 1. Gravitational compression arises as a consequence of gravitational instability, an idea that was suggested as far back as Newton. The English astronomer James Jeans showed that an infinite homogeneous medium is unstable. A contraction that begins at a large enough scale will continue due to gravity. The minimum critical size of the region from which spontaneous contraction is possible is called the Jeans wavelength. And now, let's take a look at some mathematics. Let's consider the problem of compressing a cloud of finite size lambda occupying the volume lambda cubed. And let's assume this cloud to be homogeneous and to have a density rho equals to n multiply m, where m is an average mass of a single particle and n is the concentration of particles in the cloud. Then the mass corresponding to the scale lambda will be big M, which equals to rho multiply lambda cubed. Now let's take a look at the full energy of a cloud, which is E0. E0 consists of two terms, the gravitational energy of all the particles in the cloud, which is negative, and thermal energy, which is positive. The cloud under the influence of its own gravity will begin to shrink, but only if its total energy is negative. This condition means that the gravitational forces tending to compress the cloud exceed the forces of gas pressure tending to disperse it. And after some simple mathematical transformations, we can get the critical values for the size and mass of the cloud. If we calculate this taking into account several assumptions that you can see here, we get that the scale lambda should be about 2 multiplied by 10 in the power of 17 meters. For comparison, the size of the solar system is about 3 multiplied by 10 in the power of 16 meters. And for the mass, we get that it should be about 10 in the power of 33 kilograms, which is about 500 solar masses. Actually, this cloud should be really huge. However, there are no stars of such masses, because once the gravitational contraction begins, the density of the cloud increases, while the temperature remains nearly unchanged. The rarefied and transparent medium rapidly exposes the gravitational energy released by the contraction, mostly in the form of quanta in the infrared region of the spectrum, emitted by atoms and molecules. This almost isothermal compression leads to a decrease of the Jeans wavelength, which means that gravitational instability must arise at smaller scales in the contracting cloud itself. The same can happen with newly formed clouds. This phenomenon is called cascading fragmentation. The gravitational instability can be caused by various factors, such as two clouds colliding, a cloud passing through a dense arm of a spiral galaxy, or a supernova explosion at a sufficiently close distance, whose shockwave may collide with a molecular cloud. In addition, star formation is greatly increased as a result of galaxy collisions. By the way, check my video about galaxy collisions in the description. Gravitational contraction ceases when the density increases so much that the matter becomes opaque to its own radiation, which accumulates and heats the gas. This is how a stable pre-stellar body, a protostar, emerges in the interior of the contracting cloud. This completes the first stage of new star formation. And now, let's take a look at the three-dimensional star creation simulation that I have created using smoothed particle hydrodynamics method. If you like this video, please leave a like, subscribe to my channel, and share it with your friends. If this video gets 30 likes, I will do a second part, where I will talk about the processes that occur in protostars. And surely, we will meet again.